What are the five books that every software professional should own, read, keep them besides your bed? Actually, there are seven books. Two books are in bonus. So watch the full video. At number five is The Pragmatic Programmer. If you are not convinced about the Agile methodology, what kind of advantages Agile methodology gives to the developers, you may think, okay, Agile methodology is great for business people. It gives more value to business. It's iterative. Business people are in charge. What is there for programmers? The three things I liked from the book was, first thing was broken window. What is a broken window? How the code quality became so bad in some code bases that they stink. It's very difficult to change anything on in those code bases. So it came with a broken window theory. What urban police, they saw when a window was broken in high-rise building, if the owner didn't fix the building, other things followed. People started throwing the paint on the walls of the windows. They took away more things, trashed the whole more building. Ultimately, whole building became trash. Now, but urban police does it. If there is something small broken, they make sure that it's fixed by the house owners. Second great concept from the book was tracer bullets. How you hit the actual mark? You try with the fake bullets and then you hit with the actual bullet. That's what we need to do in iterative Agile methodology. We need to try to meet the requirement till we meet the requirements. And final, the good concept was from the book was to use tools. I used to think bad programmer use tools. Real programmers do coding hard way. This book again changed my mind that you need to use tools to be more productive. Nothing wrong in using tools to, if you can get some tool to generate code for you, the regular code, use it. The fourth book that every software professional should own is Fundamentals of Software Architecture by Mark Richards, Neil Ford. If you guys are fed up reading architecture book which had only theory, very old concepts, examples related to anything other than software projects, this book is right book for you. The three good points from the book is this is very contemporary book. It talks about all the modern architecture, how they are relevant to which situation. Second good tip from the book is it gives you a lot of engineering tools. It gives you a lot of metrics, measures, which you can use to find out the architecture of any application, not only your application, other applications also. A lot of time people, they have 100% code coverage. They are using dependency injection. So it gives you a lot of tools, engineering tools, framework you can use to find out what is the architectural health of the application, how you can improve it. So I would say if you are interested in architecture, it is a must-have book for you. On number three, I have two books that everybody should read. One is Refactoring by Martin Fowler and other is Clean Code by Uncle Bob. Lot of time we get a code base and the code is written so badly, we don't know how to fix it. So in the Refactoring, Martin Fowler came with some very good examples. What are the code smells? Some code smells, I see lot of code in a function, in a file. So he gives you what are kind of smells are there, a function doing too much, a function has too many lines of code, too many parameters are being passed between function. He gives you a solution how to fix that bad code. What is refactoring? Refactoring is you change the structure of the code without changing the behavior of the code. And clean code book is like, what is clean code? Clean code is which makes sense to others, which is maintainable, which is prone to less errors. So Uncle Bob gives you some good principles, some good tips, practices, how to write clean code. Our number two is Object-Oriented Analysis and Design by Grady Boach. This book is for advanced object-oriented programmers. If you know some kind of object-oriented programming, but you struggle with the advanced, concepts, this is a very good book that you should buy. If you are some serious server-side programming, you must read this book. It is written by Grady Boach. I think this is the Bible or best book on object-oriented programming. He talks why programming is hard and how object-oriented programming solves the complex problems in the world. What are the common patterns in the complex organizations, complex business domain, and how you can use different concepts of object-oriented programming to solve that problem. So our number one book that everybody should have is, I have two books on the top. One is Design Patterns by Gang of Four, and second is Head First Design Patterns. So you should have two books. Why I saying two books? Design Patterns by Gang of Four is written C++, whereas Head First is in Java. So again, Design Pattern is the Bible of design patterns. So Christopher was an architect in housing industry, and he found out that whenever we build house, we don't have to find a new pattern. There are existing patterns we can use to build house. So these four guys took this concept from housing industry to the software industry. In the software industry, it was very difficult for a new programmer to learn the good concepts, object-oriented programming concepts. So they came with a design pattern which fixed some existing problem so that these new programmers can learn these designs and come up with solution. So again, if you want to be architect, designer, it's a must read book. Lot of design patterns are so common, like factory or command pattern, that you may not realize you are using design pattern. And Head First Design Pattern is a great book because it simplifies a very complex subject into simple one. It has a very hilarious, funny examples. And it shows you that teaching a very complex subject can be made fun, easy to read. So friends, if you like this video, I have detailed book analysis of these books. I will put links in the description. Do read that. Also like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel for your regular updates. Connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn. If you like small summaries of the video, I will be posting a lot of small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.